Welcome back to Sustainable Monetized Websites, a series for online content creators and content managers who also handle monetization. I'm Aurora, and I work in policy transparency at Google. And these are my two co-hosts, Organica and Monetized. Don't look so blue. They have done something slightly wrong, and I've given them a timeout. In this episode, we will talk about what happens when you get a manual action or a policy violation on your content and what you can do to fix them. Let me start by saying, if your site violates the Google Webmaster Quality Guidelines or any of our Google Publisher policies, you might get a manual action or suspension in your content monetization. Like in soccer or football, depending on the offense, you might experience a yellow card, a temporary timeout, or a red card, a permanent removal from the game. Let's kick this off, shall we? Google issues a manual action against a site when one of the reviewers on our web spam team determines that pages on the site are not compliant with Google's Webmaster Quality Guidelines. Most manual actions address attempts to manipulate our search index. The result? If a site has a manual action, the affected pages or the entire site will be ranked lower or omitted from search results with no visual indication to the user. Let us give you some history on why manual actions exist.
Ever since search engines were born, bad actors have tried to trick their way to the top of the results page. This is not great for users because relevant pages get buried under irrelevant results. And it's bad for legitimate websites because they become harder to find. For these reasons, we've been working since the earliest day of Google to keep search results clean and in turn fight spammers, helping people find the answers they're looking for and helping legitimate websites get traffic from search. Our algorithms are really good at detecting spam, and in most cases, we automatically discover it and remove it from our search results. However, to protect the quality of our index, we take manual actions in some cases to deal with spam from our search results.
And what are some of those cases? Spam. It can take the form of pure spam, user-generated spam, which you can learn more about in episode 5, spammy-free host, among other examples. Misleading or incorrect structured data. Unnatural links to or from your site. Thin content with little or no added value. You can learn more on episode 4. Cloaking. Showing users one thing and showing search engines something completely different. Significant content mismatch between web and AMP pages. Sneaky redirects. Google News and Discover policy violations. Organica, I give you a yellow card. Do you now understand why? Apparently I have spammy content on my site. But we talked about this in previous episodes. I think I was hacked. Well, it's still your website and you're responsible for what you publish. Whether your site has been hacked or not, you need to clean that up. That said, if you really think you've been hacked, check out the links about security issues in the description box below. In any case, if your site is affected by a manual action, we will notify you in the manual actions report and in the Search Console Message Center. Creating a healthy digital advertising ecosystem is not easy. We need to balance the needs of users, advertisers, and publishers alike. Our team of policy specialists will disable ad serving to a page or site when they find that a Google AdSense, AdMob, or Ad Manager account is not compliant with our program policies. This is done to protect users and advertisers. It is important that you review your notifications to learn the exact reason why ad serving was disabled. And what am I supposed to look out for? As I was saying before, maintaining trust in the ads ecosystem requires setting limits on what content publishers can monetize. All publishers are required to adhere to our policies and restrictions. What's the difference between them? Google publisher policies outline the types of content we won't monetize through any of our publisher products. Some examples include policies against invalid traffic or content that is illegal, sexually explicit, or dangerous or derogatory. This is content that will never be allowed to show ads. and if you try to do so, you will receive a red card. By contrast, Google publisher restrictions outline the types of content that don't necessarily violate policy, but that may not be appealing for all advertisers, such as tobacco or recreational drugs. This means that publishers will not receive a policy violation when trying to monetize content about those topics, but instead, the content will be labeled with an inventory restriction and will likely receive less advertising or sometimes no advertising at all, as the advertisers determine the demand. This could be more like a yellow card. Monetized, I gave you a red card. Do you now understand why?
Well, I suppose I tried to monetize content that is not policy compliant, but I understand now. What can I do?
Keep creating great content monetized, and make sure you only try to monetize those sections, pages, or sites that comply with our program policies. Organica, monetized. I have the feeling that you both understand why you were penalized. Let's take a look at what steps you need to take to get back on the game. For manual actions, you'll be notified on the Search Console Manual Actions report. Follow the information provided in this report to understand and fix it, and make sure you extend the changes to all affected pages and all different penalties if you receive several. After you've fixed all issues listed in the report, submit a review and do it with care. In your reconsideration request, state the exact issue that led to the manual action on your site, describe the steps you took to fix the issue, and document the outcome of your efforts.
And when will I know the outcome?
Reconsideration reviews may take up to several weeks. In that time, continue working on your website as you normally would. You will get a confirmation message when you send your request to inform you that the review is submitted. Resubmitting the same request before getting a final decision won't change the outcome or the review speed, so please refrain from doing so. For monetization issues, visit the Google AdSense, AdMob, or AdManager Policy Center, accessible from your account. Each issue comes with information on its type, impact, where it's been found, and how to fix it. Policy violations are marked as must fix, while publisher restrictions are not, as the available inventory for that content will be limited, but not suspended. You can request reviews for most content-related violations, such as dangerous and derogatory content, directly from the Policy Center. Some issues may require you to request a review outside the Policy Center, filing a form through the Help Center, Play Store, or Search Console. Once you fix your issues, make sure to write a good review request by first understanding the issue. Visit our Help Center to review our policies and seek advice from our Help Forum if you need more information. Second, check your entire site thoroughly. Bear in mind that the examples provided might be present in more than one page or section of your site. Third, tell us what changes you've made. Acknowledge that you understand the issue and describe in detail how you've addressed it. You may also choose to stop serving ads in the problematic inventory altogether by removing the ad code from the page, section, or site affected. After you've removed the ad code, the issue will disappear from the Policy Center within a week. And finally, understand the big picture. Keep in mind that our policies are designed to protect the entire ecosystem, which includes publishers, users, and advertisers alike. And when will I know the outcome? After you fix an issue and request a review, it may take up to a week for it to get reviewed. In some instances, it could take longer. You'll be notified about the outcome of the review via email and through an in-product notification. Remember, manual actions and publisher policy violations are in place to ensure the quality of the content and the safety and health of the ecosystem. Receiving one or more can get you temporarily or completely out of the game, so it's important that you understand what caused them and that you take remediation seriously. In the next episode, we'll talk about copyright, how to report infringements, and how they can affect your content. Don't forget to like and share this video and subscribe to this channel so that you're the first one to get new videos. See ya!